Hello, and welcome to Morning Meditations. My name is Jennifer Evanko, and I am so happy you are here to join us in this deep, soul-nourishing meditation. We begin each morning at 7:30 Eastern with a guided meditation for about 10 to 15 minutes. During this time, we connect with each other in a virtual circle, raising our collective energy and creating a coherent field. This is then followed by 30 minutes with your personal practice, whether you use a mantra, breath, mindfulness, prayer, or any other meditation technique. You will have time now in this collective field for your own practice. We then end the meditation with a short inspirational reading. Together, we create such a beautiful way to start your day. So join us any day or every day at either 7:30 a.m. or 10:30 a.m. Eastern. Enjoy. Namaste.
Good morning, everyone. Let's begin. With your eyes open, let's look upon the flame of your candle, or imagine the flame. Remembering when we light the fire, it is the same fire lit around the world and throughout time. This flame that connects you through time and space to all the mysteries of the past, the mysteries of the present, and the mysteries of the future. As we greet the elemental fire, we recognize its masculine energy, the hot fire of the sun. We recognize the feminine energy, the cool fire of the moon. This fire, the flame dancing on our candle, is the witness of our gathering and the mirror of a divine spark within, our internal flame. We work in the light of this flame as the eternal flame supporting us in our collective becoming and illumination. So now let's close our eyes and begin to make yourself very comfortable, relaxing just as fully as you can. And for a little while now, with your eyes closed, let's bring the awareness to the breath. As you breathe in and out, without changing the breath, just be aware of how you breathe in and out. Feeling that settling peace, a stillness, as you begin to flow with your breath in and out. As you breathe, notice the air as it passes your nose. Now deepening your breath just a little, and notice your chest rise and fall with each breath, in and out. And now deepening your breath into those long, slow belly breaths, in through the nose, Hold. Out through the mouth. Hold. And continue. As you breathe, imagine breathing in a sky blue color, a sky blue energy, allowing it to fill your body. Each breath in, a gentle wave of this sky blue energy, this prana that nourishes your body. Each breath out, breathing out stress and tension, as if it's the color gray. Imagine now that you follow your breath into our circle, finding yourself here with this beautiful soul group, all breathing the same breath. Becoming aware of a person on your right and a person on your left, others around the circle, sharing in this beautiful breath, in the stillness and peace. You now to put your hands out to either side and imagine holding hands around the circle. And as you breathe, breathing in that sky blue color in through the right hand, flowing it through your heart, out the left hand, and around the circle, touching each person, and then coming back to you in the right hand. Flowing through your heart, out the left, and around the circle. Moving this prana energy and tracing our circle with your awareness and your breath. You may begin to notice a little tingling, a little warmth in the palms of your hands. And just be aware of that energy moving around the circle, tracing the sacred circle, weaving together as a conscious collective. Raising our frequencies now, the energy of who we are. Considering for a moment all that you are grateful for in this moment. The people, the places, the things that bring you joy. In the right hand, flowing through your heart, out the left, and around the circle. Breathing that in, that joy and that gratitude. Filling your whole being with that sense, that expansion. And then sharing that with the energy around the circle. Flowing with that breath in and the breath out. Perfect balance. Now I invite you to bring to mind a dream of yours. Something that you would really like to accomplish. Just with your awareness on your heart center, allow this dream to take form. And noticing again that energy that we've created, this field of love and joy and pure potential. I invite you just to release the dream into the energy as if you're releasing it to the universe. As you release your dream into the energy, surrender yourself back into that peace, that stillness. Knowing that you've planted the seed and the universe will work out the details. Intentions and desires are supported by cosmic intelligence. Om Ritam Namaha. My intentions and desires are supported by cosmic intelligence. Om Ritam Namaha. My intentions and desires are supported by cosmic intelligence. Now take a deep breath in and release, allowing yourself to slip into that gentle resting rhythm. And begin our meditation. I'll watch the time. And now, gently continuing with your eyes closed, release the breath, the mantra, the practice. And beginning to follow your breath back into the body, into this time and into this moment. Beginning to feel your fingers and your toes and stretching just a little. Relaxing back into your chair as I read to you today from Deepak Chopra's Seven Spiritual Laws. Today, Thursday, is the law of intention and desire. The fifth spiritual law is the law of intention and desire. This law is based on the fact that energy and information exist everywhere in nature. In fact, at the level of the quantum field, there is nothing other than energy and information. The quantum field is just another label for the field of pure consciousness or pure potentiality. And this quantum field is influenced by intention and desire, because intent is desire without attachment to the outcome. Desire alone is weak, because desire in most people is attention with attachment. Intention combined with detachment leads to life-centered, present moment awareness. And when action is performed in present moment awareness, it is most effective. Your intent is for the future, but your attention is in the present. As long as your attention is in the present, then your intent for the future will manifest, because the future is created in your present. You must accept the present as it is. Accept the present and intend the future. The future is something you can always create through detached intention, but you should never struggle against the present. The past, the present, and future are all properties of consciousness. The past is recollection, memory. The future is anticipation. The present is awareness. Therefore, time is the movement of thought. Both past and future are born in the imagination. Only the present, which is awareness, is real and eternal. Here are three ways to apply the law of intention and desire. First, make a list of all your desires and carry this list with you wherever you go. Look at it from time to time before you go into silence and meditation. And look at it before you go to sleep at night. And then look at it again in the morning. 2. Release this list of desires and surrender to the womb of creation, trusting that when things don't seem to go your way, there is a reason, and that the cosmic plan has a design for you that is much grander than the one you have chosen for yourself. 3. Remind yourself to practice present moment awareness in all of your actions. Refuse to allow obstacles to consume or dissipate the quality of your attention in the present moment. Accept the present as it is and manifest the future through your deepest, most cherished intentions and desires. Thursday, the law of intention and desire. Namaste, and have a beautiful day.